I saw you have met with me in Singapore at the security conference. He gave a very strong speech. I think it was very received very well by those here who stand for freedom. And, you know, Joe's father and mine fought World War II, mine in the European theater against the Nazis. And Joe, his father, was a flying tiger. And we see ourselves as liberators for freedom, and we stand shoulder to shoulder in this great alliance that we have, and so many things we can do working together. Also very pleased about the new alliance between South Korea, Japan, Philippines. We'll be traveling to Australia after this, my past AUKUS, the UK, Australian. Pillar 1 and 2, which deals with our strength in the region to counter aggression that we've seen unfold in the last several years. And so we came here to say thank you as well. The supplemental is very important to get passed. We see, whether it was Israel to Ukraine to Indo-Pacific, three areas of the world, these three regions are under attack from tyrannical governments. We see President Putin and Chairman Xi made their alliance in Beijing, along with the Ayatollah and Kim Jong-un. And we have to defend freedom from those forces. The supplemental had $2 billion for foreign military financing. But I made sure that the Philippines were included in that $500 million for military financing that I know you just met with the Secretary of State and Defense, Secretary Blinken and Secretary Austin. I understand you had a very good series of meetings with good outcomes and deliverables, and we look forward to working with you. I work very closely with them on this funding. I'm also very enthusiastic about the economy. You have a very young and vibrant economy with a young generation of people. I introduced and passed the CHIPS bill, and I understand you just got a CHIPS grant from Secretary of Commerce Raimondo, which is fantastic. Right? And I really see the Philippines as a place where, as we try to move semiconductor manufacturing out of areas that are more under threat, like say in Taiwan, we can move them to countries like the Philippines. So I don't want to talk too long, but I did want to and say thank you to the National Security Advisor for being here, and to Secretaries of Defense and State. Thank you for being here as well. You're always welcome in D.C. You have friends there, and we always love to see you.
Well, we're certainly watching closely for all the extremely interesting developments that are ongoing in this for your political cycle. You're coming right up already to the finish line.
Yeah.
With things still very much in play. On the economic side of the alliance, again, the support that we have received and the interest that has been shown both by the government United States and the private sector players in the specific areas. That's right. When I came, the subject matter and the